So good evening everyone and welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247 where I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exam and especially for the upcoming RBI GATE exam. And yesterday, Wednesday ko session nahi ho paya tha because there were not enough news to be covered and I really don't want to waste your time. So in today's session we are going to do 10 questions. Aaj ke session mein 10 questions hai and out of 10 questions I would say 5-6 questions are such which have huge chances of asking in your examination. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, you can enroll in this crash course which is exclusively launched for this year's RBI Grade B exam. And if you want to enroll in this course, you can download the Amazon app from the Google Play Store. In this app, you can get everything related to examinations like monthly GK exam updates, proper strategies, etc. etc. And if you want to ask anything related to examination, you can follow me here. And also, if you want to have the PDF of this session with marked answers, you can join the Telegram channel and the link for which is provided in the description. Alright, so let's move ahead to the very first question, very very important question. Which of the following payment banks has launched Pincluvation to collaborate with fintech startup community to co-create and innovate solutions for the financial inclusion? Alright, so very basic question. एंड अगर क्वेश्चन आया एग्जाम में तो वो यही क्वेश्चन होगा एग्जैक्ट कि कौन से पेमेंट बैंक ने फिनक्लुवेशन को लॉन्च किया है. ठीक है, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट दिस. रिमेंबर इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक. इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक हैज लॉन्च्ड फिनक्लुवेशन इन एसोसिएशन विद द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पोस्ट ऑफकोर्स बिकॉज इंडिया पोस्ट पेमेंट बैंक वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड नॉट अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस. Please remember this. And this innovation has been launched for collaboration with fintech startup community so that they can create and innovate solutions for the financial inclusion. ताकि financial inclusion के लिए solutions create किए जा सके, उसके लिए this innovation has been launched by India Post Payment Bank. Alright, this innovation will invite startups to participate, ideate, develop and market all the innovative products and services that can be taken to the customers. And also it will allow the startups to grow with IPPB, which is India Post Payment Bank, and Department of Post experts to develop solutions and conduct pilots using the postal network of the Department of Post. Alright, so basically all these things, isme aapko sirf kya kya cheeze yaad rakhni hai, you have to remember that it has been launched by India Post Payment Bank. And what is the objective? Okay, objective is that under this innovation, under this initiative, they will collaborate with fintech startup community so that they can create and innovate solutions for the financial inclusion. That's it. And of course, the name of the initiative, that is Pincluvation. Alright, so therefore, the correct answer, guys, will be what? Because the question is regarding which payment bank. So that's India Post Payment Bank is the correct answer. It is headquartered in New Delhi. And who is the MD and CEO? It is Mr. J. Venkat Ramu. J. Venkat Ramu is the MD and CEO of this bank. Of course, it is the only government-owned payment bank. Moving ahead to the next question. Which of the following statements is incorrect with respect to Atal Pension Yojana? And I believe aap sabne is scheme ka naam suna hoga, aur agar nahi suna hai is scheme ka naam, so there is some problem. You need medicines in that case. Alright. अटल पेंशन योजना बहुत पुरानी स्कीम है, 2015 में लॉन्च हुई थी. बट द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई इट इज इन न्यूज, व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इट. सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इट बिकॉज़ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस हैज डिक्लेयर्ड दैट द टोटल एनरोलमेंट्स अंडर दिस स्कीम अटल पेंशन योजना हैव टच्ड अ 4.01 करोड़ मार्क ऑन मार्च 2022. ठीक है, और जिसमें से 99 लाख सब्सक्राइबर्स जो थे, 99 लाख अकाउंट्स पिछले फाइनेंशियल ईयर में ओपन हुए थे, दैट वाज इन द फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2022 एंड दैट इज व्हाई अटल पेंशन योजना इज इन न्यूज. सो व्हेनेवर एनी स्कीम इज इन न्यूज यू हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट दैट बिकॉज़ देयर इज अ चांस कि वहां से क्वेश्चन आ जाए. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट अटल पेंशन योजना. सो रिमेंबर एज द नेम सजेस्ट इट इज अ पेंशन बेनिफिट स्कीम अंडर विच पेंशन सिक्योरिटी बेसिकली ओल्ड एज इनकम सिक्योरिटी इज प्रोवाइडेड टू द सिटीजंस स्पेशली दोज हु आर द पुअर who are the underprivileged and who are the workers in the unorganized sector. And as I already told you, it was launched in 2015 and it is being implemented by Ministry of Finance and not the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. It is a social welfare scheme, but it is not implemented by social justice and empowerment. Please remember this. And what is the eligibility to enroll in this particular scheme? So minimum age should be 18 years, maximum age is 40, maximum can be 40 years. Bank account owner chahiye, that must be linked with Aadhaar card. And if a member of any other social security scheme opens his APY account, then government co-contribution will not be provided. If I am a person who is already enrolled for any pension benefit scheme in the government of India, then in that case, government co-contribution will not be provided into my Atal Pension Yojana account. Alright? Pension amount can be rupees 1000 to rupees 5000. That depends on your contribution. That depends upon the subscriber's contribution. And of course, the pension fund manager for this is Pension Fund Regulatory Development Authority of India, PFRDA. PFRDA is headquartered in New Delhi, and Mr. Dhruv Pratim Bandyopadhyay is the chairperson of PFRDA. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. So it was launched in 2014. No, it was launched in 2015. Fixed pension of 3000 is given. Is that so? No, pension varies from 1000 to 5000. That depends on the subscriber's contribution. Pension fund manager is not LIC, it is PFRDA. And it is being implemented by Ministry of Finance, that's absolutely correct. And minimum age to enroll is 18 years. So option B must be, that is the correct answer. Because we have to identify the correct statement. Alright, and only option B is correct. Moving ahead to question number 3. Consider the following statements with respect to DESH scheme, and you have to identify the correct statement. Very, very important scheme or very, very important question. Exam mein bahut zyada chances hai iske aane ke question. Especially jo abhi RBI ka exam hone wala hai. So this is the new scheme which has been launched by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. And this ministry is headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar. You remember this also. And what is the Lok Sabha constituency of Dr. Virendra Kumar? It's Tikamgarh. Jahan se 1996 se MP hai ye. So let's talk about this scheme. Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment has launched this DESH scheme, which stands for Dr. Ambedkar Center of Excellence. DESH stands for what? Dr. Ambedkar Center of Excellence. Now, it is very clear from the name of the scheme itself that some kind of center of excellence will be established under this scheme. Now, what type of center of excellence will these? So, iski baat hum karte hain. Remember, these center of excellence will be set up to provide high quality, free coaching facilities to the ST candidates for the civil service examinations, which are conducted, of course, by UPSC. ठीक है, so basically क्या है, free coaching facility दी जाएगी to the ST students and for what? For the civil service examination which are being conducted every year by UPSC. Alright, the nodal agency for implementing this scheme is Dr. Ambedkar Foundation. Basically, Dr. Ambedkar Foundation is responsible for establishment of these centers of excellence. Okay, total strength per center will be 100. And out of this 133% reservation will be provided to the female SC candidates. Now, how will they select? Because in a center, the maximum strength is 100. So there must be some criteria of selection, right? So the students will be selected on the basis of an entrance exam, which will be conducted by the university as per merit. And remember, these centers of excellence will be established in 31 universities. 30 universities will be established. Yes. Again. Yes. And Dr. Ambedkar Foundation, of course, because it is the nodal agency, so it will fund the establishment of these center of excellence, and rupees 75,000 per annum per student will be provided to the university for 100 students, which means 75 lakh rupees will be provided to each university or institution in which this center of excellence is going to be established. Alright. So I hope this scheme is clear. इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, इतना काफ़ी है. Alright, so वैसे सब कुछ मैंने कवर कर ही दिया है, इसमें कुछ बचा नहीं है. Now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statements. So Dr. Ambedkar Foundation is the nodal agency. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Total strength per center will be 200 students. So क्या 200 होगा? No, the total strength will be 100 students. Rupees 75,000 per annum per student will be provided to the university for implementation. बिल्कुल सही बात है. 50% seats are reserved for the female candidates. This is not so. The reservation percentage is 33%. So second and fourth are incorrect, but you have to identify the correct. Okay, so 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. 1 and 3, right? Because we have to identify correct statement. Yes. So option A, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4, which is again based on a scheme. Dr. Ambedkar Foundation is implementing Dr. Ambedkar Chairs Scheme in universities or institutions all over the country. What amount is given initially for establishment of the chair in the university? Now please don't go into the details of this scheme. Let me tell you this. नहीं पूछा जाएगा. Examiner जब question बना रहा होगा तो वो इस scheme का official document खोल के नहीं देखेगा. Don't worry. वो सिर्फ उतना ही देखेगा जितना कि PIB में given है. ठीक है? So let's talk about this. Dr. Ambedkar Foundation is implementing this Dr. Ambedkar Chairs Scheme. And as the name suggests, it is very clear that Ambedkar chairs are being established under this particular scheme in various universities and institutions across the country. And it provides an opportunity to academicians to understand, access, assess, disseminate, and implement the ideas and thoughts of the great B.R. Ambedkar. Okay? And there are some other important things about this scheme. Rupees 75 lakh is given as grant in it. Earlier this was rupees 35 lakh. But now it has been increased to 75 lakh. Grant in aid diya jayega to all these chairs. But initially, at the time of establishment, rupees 10 lakh is being given to the university for their establishment. Okay? And currently there are 24 chairs in the country in various institutions and universities. Alright. So now let's come back to the question. What amount is given initially? So rupees 10 lakh is given initially for the establishment of these chairs by Dr. Ambedkar Foundation. Alright, now let's move ahead to question number 5. With which of the following international organizations, NITI Aayog, has signed a statement of intent to develop the first report on the state of India's children, status and trends in multidimensional child development? So like we have a multidimensional poverty index, so NITI Aayog will in future come up with a report on multidimensional child development. So the question is, with which international organization the statement of intent has been signed for development of this report? Okay, so this is a very easy question and very direct question. This is UNICEF. So this statement of intent has been signed with UNICEF, and it is very clear that it has been signed for the development of this report, multi-dimensional child development report. Alright, इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. And of course, UNICEF executive director, the newly appointed Catherine Russell is the newly appointed executive director of UNICEF. Alright, so therefore the correct answer will be what? Option B, UNICEF. And now let's move ahead to question number 6. Where has India's first pure green hydrogen pilot plant been commissioned by Oil India Limited? Very, very important question. ये phase 1 के लिए भी important है और phase 2 में जो 1 marker होते हैं उसके लिए भी important है. ठीक है, ESI में, because it is, you can consider it from the topic environmental economics. तो वहां पे ये question पूछा जा सकता है. And of course, green hydrogen वाली चीजें तो चली गई है हमारे देश में. ठीक है. Now let me ask you a question here. What is the target of production of green hydrogen by the year 2030 of the government of India? Write down in the comments. देखते हैं कि जिनको पता है और कितनों को नहीं पता. नहीं पता होगा तो मैं बता दूंगा नेक्स्ट सेशन में. So this India's first pure green hydrogen pilot plant has been commissioned in Jorhat, which is in Assam. And also remember that it was commissioned by Oil India Limited. The name of the company is also important. Oil India Limited. Moving ahead to the next question, with which organizations DPIIT, which is Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, has organized investors roundtable to boost investor confidence and take cognizance of industry level policy recommendations to enhance investor business equilibrium? ये सारी चीजें बेकार है, ये सब आपकी किसी काम की नहीं है. Just remember, DPIIT has organized this investors roundtable to boost the confidence of the investors in collaboration with Invest India. That's it. Option C. फालतू की चीजों पे ध्यान मत दिया करो. क्वेश्चन को लंबा इसीलिए किया जाता है ताकि आपका टाइम वेस्ट हो. तो आपको थोड़ा सा स्मार्ट वर्क करना है ड्यूरिंग द एग्जामिनेशन एज वेल. ठीक है, जब आप एग्जाम लिख रहे हो तो थोड़ा सा स्मार्ट वर्क किया करो. ऐसे ही गवर्नमेंट स्कीम में भी होता है. सेम थिंग हैपेंस इन द गवर्नमेंट स्कीम, एक बहुत बड़ा पैसेज दे दिया जाता है एंड यू जस्ट हैव टू रीड द पैसेज एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चंस दैट फॉलो। ठीक है, क्वेश्चंस बहुत इजी होते हैं, तो जल्दी से इस पे नजर मारने की कोशिश किया करो कि ये ठीक है, कीवर्ड्स आइडेंटिफाई किया करो कि कौन से कीवर्ड्स गिवन है, उसमें से इजीली आइडेंटिफाई किया जा सकता है दैट व्हिच स्कीम इज दिस। ठीक है, और ये सारी चीजें हम प्रैक्टिस कर रहे हैं थ्रू द रिवीजन सेशंस। इफ यू गाइस आर नॉट अटेंडिंग दोस, प्लीज अभी संडे को भी सेशन है, यू कैन जॉइन दैट। सो दिस क्वेश्चन द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन सी, इन्वेस्ट इंडिया। क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 पे चलते हैं। इन विच स्टेट और यूपी एवीआईसी व्हिच इज खादी विलेज इंडस्ट्रीज कमीशन हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड द हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड सर्विस यूनिट्स अंडर इट्स फ्लैगशिप स्कीम व्हिच इज प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन प्रोग्राम पीएमईजीपी। सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट पीएमईजीपी। पीएमईजीपी के अंडर केवीआईसी ने सबसे ज्यादा मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट कौन से स्टेट या कौन से यूटी में लगाए हैं? ठीक है, ओवरऑल पूछा है। ठीक है, आउट ऑफ ऑल 36 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज, आउट ऑफ ऑल 36 स्टेट्स एंड यूटीज, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, ऑप्शन ई, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर में सबसे ज्यादा केवीआईसी ने मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट लगाए हैं। सो इट इज जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, यूनियन टेरिटरी ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर इन विच केवीआईसी हैज एस्टैब्लिश्ड द हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स अंडर पीएमईजीपी। एंड ऑफ कोर्स केवीआईसी चेयरपर्सन इज मिस्टर विनय कुमार सक्सेना। क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 पे आ जाओ। Which of the following ports will organize Incredible India International Cruise Conference in May 2022? Very easy question, very direct question. There is no need to go into the detail. It will be organized in Mumbai port on 14th and 15th May 2022. Alright. So option A, Mumbai port is the correct answer. And the last question for today. Which of the following districts has emerged as the best performing district in the category of Promoting excellence in sports and wellness through Khelo India scheme in PM's Award for Excellence in Public Administration. Very recently, we have discussed about this PM's Award for Excellence in Public Administration, in which we have discussed that our scheme has got this award. But now, this question is about in the category of promoting excellence in sports and wellness through Khelo India. So, in this category, this award has been given to the district Chunu. Chunu is in Rajasthan. So this is the best performing district, followed by Bishnupur of Manipur, followed by Bishnupur district of Manipur. Alright, so only two awards were given in this category. Number one is Churu, which is in Rajasthan. Number two is Bishnupur, which is in Manipur. Alright. So that's it for the session today. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next session on Monday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.